Tiene una buena quijada, pero pega fuerte. Y a veces Ryan García no sabemos cómo va a reaccionar, especialmente después de la derrota que tuvo con Tank Davis.
Oscar, the emotion is definitely here between these two fighters. Where does that all stem from? That's my question.
I think it stems from Ryan Garcia's loss. How he's going to react against a power puncher, because Ryan Garcia just got knocked out by a power puncher, and now he's facing a power puncher. So people are curious how he's going to react, how he's going to step up against a guy who's never been dropped, a guy who has a hell of a chin. So yeah, it's a very interesting fight.
You have ties to Houston way back. You were one of the first investors in the dynasty.
Sure.
Now they're Western Conference Finals. Will you follow them?
Absolutely. I will follow them till the end. Look, I was actually one of the first investors in the group, and yeah, I always wish them all the best. You know, they're in great hands. I see they're doing very well. I'm a huge fan, so yeah, I wish them all the best. I think they come all the way to the top, and this is just the beginning. So, you know, I had the investment, excuse me, for a very long time, and just like any other businessman, you once you hold on to investments for so long, you have to release them and make your profit. So, but one thing for me is that the team is very dear to my heart. They're winners. They're in the town where they believe, they breathe, they love soccer. So yeah, it's exciting to see them in the Western Conference Finals.
I remember when you became involved, but also you got ties to Houston. You spent more time there, and then you realized what fertile ground this was to promote boxing.
Absolutely. I mean, I remember promoting Baby Bull against Raul Marquez. I remember promoting some very, very great fights here in Houston. So we know the foundation is here. It's a great fan base, and that's what we're doing.
Las palabras que de Ryan García que le hicieron solo me sorprende las palabras de Ryan García, que la verdad pues insulta a la empresa.
No,
a ti
no,
y a Bernardo.
No me sorprende para nada, no me sorprende para nada, porque él tiene una mentalidad de niño. ¿Y qué pasa cuando le quitas un juguete a un niño? Empieza a llorar. Yo creo que obviamente no dice que yo le quite un juguete, pero no es maduro de la cabeza, y yo creo que esta pelea va a ser una pelea difícil, fuerte, y veremos cómo va a reaccionar.
¿Cuál será la solución para, pues, más que nada cerrarse esta amistad y seguir adelante trabajando con Ryan?
Este es un negocio. Yo voy a ser promotor por el resto de mi vida. Un Ryan García, peleadores pelean por 10 años, 15 años, sean campeones mundiales, sean héroes, leyendas, claro. Se retiran, pero yo como promotor, yo voy a hacer mi trabajo, es todo.
Claro que sí, hablando de peleas grandes, Jaime Munguía es el mandatorio para Canelo Álvarez. Sé que estuviste cenando con David Benavides. ¿Cuál sería la pelea ideal, digamos, como para, si tú, para la afición, la mejor pelea entre Canelo,
pues veremos,
Munguía o Benavides?
Porque Jaime Munguía quiere pelear y va a pelear con los mejores del mundo, ¿ok? Ya es tiempo, ya está listo. Yo creo que Jaime Munguía contra Benavides sería bueno, contra Canelo. Jaime Munguía ahorita está en una posición en donde él puede elegir con quién va a pelear, porque está joven y está madurando, está creciendo como peleador. Y nada, yo creo que el 5 de mayo, y yo siempre lo he dicho, una pelea entre dos mexicanos campeones no la hemos visto en mucho tiempo. Yo me recuerdo los tiempos de Julio César Chávez con Azabache Martínez, dos mexicanos, pelea, pero un peleón, ¿verdad? Así que es lo que quiero ver. Y veremos a ver qué pasa.
¿Cómo estuvo esa cena con David Benavides? Porque sé que lo conoce muy bien.
Muy bien.
Siempre después
bien,
de las victorias,
sí,
siempre cena muy bien.
Muy bien.
¿Qué consejo
la familia,
fue lo que?
La verdad que es una una familia muy agradable. Me quiere mucho como héroe, como leyenda. Me respeta mucho, así que yo no le doy muchos consejos a él, así que la verdad que es un placer.
¿Sí le gana?
Conference here, Ryan Garcia is 5%, but the whole focus really was compared to Oscar Duarte. Mine has been a little bit bothered about what Bernard said. The fans have been saying that this could have brought me to the stage a little bit more. I had a meeting personally between y'all. For maybe after the fight, Brian's performance, maybe setting up a meeting and just his men sitting down and just erasing all of this, per se.
Well, if you take a look at the interview that Bernard gave in the Rocha press conference, which was about 2 months ago, Bernard stated that if it was him as a legend, as a fighter, as a legendary hero, this is what he would do. He didn't say, well, this is what Ryan should do. So when you're dealing with kids, it's really hard to get across that message. And then you have Ryan saying this and that, so it's all BS.
It's 5 weeks. Do you think that's going to take away the focus away from this tough fight on Saturday? Because I want to talk to you on the first.